Hey, Jay Shrek, guess where I'm at today? Vulture City, home of the Vulture Mine. And guess who used to work there? Myths, legends, and lies. Guess where we're at today? On the journey of the lost Dutchman, right? Well, we're in a gold mine that produced more gold than any gold mine in the state of Arizona ever. And so what's the tie-in between the gold mine and the lost Dutchman is? He used to work here. Really. He worked at the Vulture Mine in Vulture City in Wickenburg, Arizona. And it's a fascinating place with its own fascinating story. I mean, this is the assay office right here. And so they produce more gold out of this gold mine than anywhere in the state of Arizona. And guess what? Jacob Waltz was one of those miners that worked here. Now, there's a myth that goes around today that maybe he was just a gold mine thief and that maybe he stole gold from the Vulture Mine and then just sold it to other assay offices. And the first thing you might ask is, well, why would he have do that? Why would he do that? Because you just couldn't go into the assay office and say, hey, here's some gold, give me some money. They wanted to know where you got that. Well, why was that? Because they wanted to make sure that you aren't a thief. So could he have concocted this story up? And maybe he would do what they call just high pocketing the gold as he was gold mining. And so stealing that gold, right? And you know what? The risk was pretty unbelievable if you got caught. But as you're going to find out in this story, many people took that on, right? Now, another fascinating thing that happened was that in the assay office, right? And we're going to go right through the same doors that these outlaws came through, right? So they came right into this door. Right? Here. And then before they delivered it, right? They took it in here. Now this was the safe. Right here. So, these two outlaws, they weren't successful, let's just put it that way. Very untimely death. So what would happen to you if you were caught stealing gold? Hold up the assay office. And one other thing. Now, real quick, what I'm going to show you is, this is the kitchen of the assay office. You know, you took care of these people because they took care of your money, right? Now, another thing is up these stairs here. That's where they lived, right? Now, if you were a guard in the assay office, they didn't even want you talking to anybody, right? Because they didn't want you communicating, even if maybe you had a few too many shots of rock gut, right? And that you might let people know when the train was going to come through, the wagon train was going to come through to pick up the gold to take it to the mill, okay? Or to the bank, depending on which grade it was. So, this was a lonely place. And they say that the two men that were killed, they come back wanting their gold back. Now let's say that you were coming on hard times, and let's say that maybe you took a risk of maybe stealing a little of that gold for yourself, you know? I mean, you made all that money and you worked so hard and all you got was a measly wage, right? So one day you concocted a way that you were going to get gold out, right? And so you did that very same thing that maybe the lost Dutchman did. And what happens? You got caught. So if you got caught stealing gold, right? So what, would they slap you on the wrist? Well, not quite. Let me show you this. That, my friend, is the hanging tree. And 18 people swung from the hanging tree. You know, I'd say they didn't play. So if you got caught stealing gold, your penalty was right here. Going to hang from the hanging tree. So in 1863, Henry Wickenburg found this location, and this is his house. Now, isn't it apropos that his house shades itself with the shade of the hanging tree? Now, that's pretty incredible in itself, right? That's pretty incredible in itself. And this is his house right here. Now, what are these holes, right? So what are these holes right here? Well, you got to remember, in 1863, this place was, let's just say that the Indians hadn't decided yet that they were going to go peacefully. And, you know, you were going to get attacked at any time by the Indians. And so these were gun ports to be able to shoot out of, right? And you were going to use them. So there's three on this side. And two on that side. So, Wickenburg ended up selling his portion of the mine for $85,000 plus $26,000. The $26,000 which he never received, right? He also invested in a guy named Jack Swilling, right? Jack Swilling had this idea that if he went to Phoenix and he reconstructed the aqueducts that the Indians had been using for crops for hundreds of years, that he could make Phoenix an agricultural paradise. And guess what? He did, and he did it with the backing of Wickenburg. Now, Wickenburg spent more money almost trying to get his $26,000 he never received back. And you know, he died. He died broke. Now, the story goes that he killed himself in Wickenburg, the town. But myth has it that the caretakers, just exactly like the Lost Dutchman, may have made it look like that. So here again, in the same kind of story, not exactly the same, but there's a little bit of that same trend. Just imagine 18 times this tree has taken the life out of people. You know, I was in one of the other buildings over here, and I got a hello just out of the blue. Somebody said hello. It happened to be the brothel. I don't know if that's good or bad. So let's talk more about what happened here. There is a rumor that they were trying to steal some of the gold, and they had taken the pillars down. But the truth of the story of that story is that there were 13 Mexican miners in there just mining. There was an earthquake in California, and it collapsed. Now, a lot of people don't know this either, that